Notice is that punk rock fans look as devastating as their music sounds. Torn clothes are held together with safety pins. There's lots of black leather and bizarre hair, and the whole idea is to shock outsiders.
But it isn't hurting people, it isn't really hurting people. It's just some of the bloody fools that come along and see it, you know, react against it.
You don't yawn, you don't have to pay £5, and you're not one of 10,000 people.
What's your dress made from?
You know, you feel one of the crowd.
What do you do?
What do I do?
You're not a mouse, you know, like Mike Oldfield fans, you know?
It was why they thought pub rock had failed to catch on.
Most of their music, though, was just based around old standards, like Bees, Mate, Onion, bands like that. They just played everybody else's songs that everybody been playing for, like, 15 years. There's a couple of bands, like The Killdings, when you're good.
They're all mostly country and western, rhythm and blues. And what the hell good juice is that, man?
What was needed was a style of music that was as easy to play as pub rock, but rejected the past and had a new identity of its own.
What musicians do you write? I mean, who do you think is a good singer?
I don't. I don't have any heroes. They're all useless. Well, there's no bands around, is there? None. None are accessible.
Well, before you...
Unless you pay a fiver to see them, and then you can't see them.
And what sort of people came to see you in the beginning?
Well, no one knew us at the beginning.
It was just whoever was there when we turned up. Because we used to turn up with our equipment and just, like, crash in and do the gigs. Nobody knew we was playing until we got there. We didn't even know, actually.
Well, you reckon that was the only way to get a gig, was just turn up first and...
Yeah, that's how only way we can get gigs.
Fucking pushing.
Come in.
Get them.
No, I'm sure.
How come?
Come
on,
Johnny.
No. What? When you stood up and started singing,
like,
the first time, what happened?
I mean.
Oh, John, go on.
It was wonderful.
No, come on.
People loved me. They threw flowers.
Well, look, I saw you the sixth time, and they were quite shell shocked.
Well, then you know yourself, don't you?
What sort of people
come to see you?
Johnny. I don't know, just bored people. Bored out their brains with hippies.
What's this thing you got against hippies?
They're complacent.
You're just attacking Chopper and Pops and the sort of bands that are on there. What, do you think they're relevant to the kids 16, 17?
Of course they're not. Relevant to their mums and dads, but that's about all.
What about bands like Rod Stewart?
What about him?
Mums and dads,
isn't it? He's all round, isn't he? All round entertainment.
He's an old f***.
Things really started to move for the Sex Pistols when they were spotted by promoter Ron Watts, who gave them a booking at the 100 Club in Oxford Street.
I'm in at first, you know. First sort of half dozen gigs were very average in support, you know. Any other band would have done as many people. But it's the actual followers that did it, you know, that turned the key.
We've been there for 5 years or more just waiting for this to happen, and now it's happened.
It's like it's only a punk way of dressing, it's just dressing exactly how, you know, how you want to look and finding clothes that are original, not like wearing everything that everyone else wears, you know, looking just a bit different.
Have you tried to get a band together?
Yeah, I did the 100 Club, the punk festival.
Susie and the Banshees.
What did you sing?
The Lord's Prayer via Twist and Shout, Knocking on Heaven's Door, and a bit of Deutschland, Deutschland, Uber Alle.
And what went down the verse?
All of it. It got boring in some parts, but it picked up.
And who was backing you up?
Sid Vicious on drums, Steve Spunker on bass, Marco on guitar, and me just doing the vocals.
Are you a singer?
Yeah.
Have you sung before?
Not on stage, no.
Did you think that was important?
To identify with. I went along to the rehearsal rooms in Camden to ask Clash.
Why do you think punk rock started in the first place?
Well, because it's like, it's got nothing to do with them anymore when like Rod Stewart gets up there and starts like going on with his string orchestra, you know what I mean? It's not what you feel like. So you've got to have some music what you feel like. Otherwise you go balmy, don't you?
I think their attitudes really stink. Now, anyway, it's just like, there just has to be new groups, and then that's what you got.
The Sex Pistols say they hate hippies, everything they stand for, and the hippies are what went wrong with music. What do you think about that?
Yeah, it's right. I think that's where the complexities came in, you know? When people thought, oh, we better buy a Moog synthesizer, or we'll get caught out, you know? Like
if
maybe
if there's any around, they should, like, you know, jump into action immediately. Because, you know, I suppose it ain't their fault. They've had too much dope.
Yeah. Lying on the floor and looking at the ceiling.
But it's another generation to yours.
Yeah, one that went wrong.
What sort of things do you write about?
What's going on at the moment.
Like what?
Like what? Career opportunities. White Riot.
Yeah, tell me about White Riot. What's it about?
Not Newgate.
Like, you know that riot they had? Well, we was down there, me and him, and we got searched by policemen looking for bricks, like, and then later on we got searched by Rasta looking for pound notes in our pocket, so...
All we had was bricks and bottles. But still...
But one of the lines in it is everybody does what they're told to.
Yeah, it's true.
I mean, do you think what's happened to a lot of young people is that they've been pushed around a lot?
Yeah,
and
well,
that your
like,
music's a bit
the school
of...
I went to, right? I mean, they're sort of like, all the kids are supposed to sort of like be factory prodder, you know, that sort of stuff. And like, the school's sort of built, it's a real sort of depressing school in that. And you go there, you don't learn nothing. All you're sort of like working for is just to go into the factory, which is around the corner, or something like that. And, well, most of the mates I know are all working in the factory.
Are a lot of your fans on the dole? I mean, do they feel the same way?
Yeah, obviously they wouldn't come to our gigs, would they?
If they weren't on the dole, would they be your fans?
Well, I mean, if there was jobs, then they wouldn't be on the dole. And maybe we'd be singing about love and kissing or something.
So the new groups claim they're singing about the situations that they and their fans find themselves in. Well, are they? The Sex Pistols' first single is aggressively called Anarchy in the UK. But what do they mean by anarchy?
Do you mean you actually
want to
destroy them, or you
want to
wipe them out?
He wants to autograph.
Complacent, apathetic, old walk up and down, do nothing, and complain about everything.
and watch Top of the Pops and send their boring little letters into Melody Maker week after week. That's what I want to get rid of.
I actually want to get rid of it, though.
Push them out.
Destroy them, eh?
Destroy them one way or another. Not violence. Get rid of them.
But don't you get off on causing fights?
Where you heard that from?
Gosh, that's rubbish. No, we're nice.
It's just the same as when it was before, when they had the Stones and the Who and they came along and they thought they were great because they destroyed everything that went before them. But now they can't take it because we're destroying everything that's gone before us. That's all it is.
It's not violence, it's just excitement causes it most of the time, you know. When we're playing, people get excited and worked up.
Mm. That's because people aren't even used to people standing up and jumping around. They just want to sit down all the time. And as soon as anything other than that happens, they get really kind
it's
of shocked.
It's considered violent.
Yeah, it's called, if someone stands up there and goes, yeah, it's...
Like, go on, right, look, he's starting. Go on, get him out.
The usual.
Violence at punk rock gigs may have been exaggerated, but they were undoubtedly based on fact. And they've led to a situation where some fans expect and even demand trouble. Ron Watts, who first introduced punk rock to London, now supports a ban on it. I asked him if he wasn't going to lose out by banning such a booming fashion.
That are liable to be violent, and we can't have those people.
Order. Get rid of it.
What do you think about bands like the Stones?
I don't. I don't even consider them a band. They're more like a business.
What a business?
Yeah, but surely by making a record, you're on the way to becoming part of the system.
No.
Not if you don't let yourself.
But supposing your record's a success.
Yeah.
I mean, which they're... Big chance, it will be.
Oh, God.
Yeah, okay, it's everyone. Supposing you make a lot of money, how are you going to be different from the Stones?
I don't need a Rolls Royce. I don't need a house in the country. I don't need to live in the south of France. I'm happy as I am and I'm going to carry on.
Finsbury Park with these bums.
Don't live in Finsbury Park.
Yeah. the feeling you've been trapped.
I ain't automatic, one for me, just I ain't static. Don't you give me any order to people like me, there is no order. That's the fact you had it, I was out. That's the fact you knew what I was about. That's the fact you thought I am your problem. Not you, all the problems.
As soon as you arrive, the licensee of this premises wants you off, so please leave now before there's any further trouble.
The reason you're here is because it's the Sex Pistols. If it wasn't the Sex Pistols, there'd be no interest in this boat tonight. We'd be having a party.
Get the power back on.
They're refusing to put the power back on.
We're not getting off.
Stapled together by two young punks from Deptford.
Punks have multicoloured hair, vampire makeup, ripped t-shirts held together with safety pins, swastika armbands, pink plastic trousers and tight leather jeans.
Because I wanted them to be like young assassins. That was the name I chose. I wanted them to be sexy young assassins.
Enjoying myself.
Are you?
Yeah.
That's what I thought you were doing. I
always wanted to meet you.
Did you really?
Yeah.
We'll meet afterwards, shall we?
You dirty son. You dirty old man.
Well, keep going, Chief. Keep going. Go on, you've got another 5 seconds. Say something outrageous.
You dirty bastard.
Go on, again.
You dirty fucker.
What a clever boy.
What a fucking rotter.
Well, that's it for the... All that...